And now, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to invite to speak a leader whose stature makes me very proud as an Indian. Please welcome her with a round of thunderous applause. Main ab nivedan karna chahungi Bharat ki maninee videsh mantri Shrimati Sushma Swaraj ji se ki ve sabha ko sambodhit kare. Please, maninee mantri ji.
भारत के सबसे बड़े प्रदेश उत्तर प्रदेश के लोकप्रिय मुख्यमंत्री आदरणीय योगी आदित्यनाथ जी, मंत्रिपरिषद में मेरे सहयोगी और आज के इस कार्यक्रम के आयोजक कर्नल राज्यवर्धन सिंह राठौर, विदेश मंत्रालय में मेरे दाहिने हाथ के रूप में काम कर रहे जनरल वीके सिंह, आज के हमारे विशेष अतिथि स्पेशल गेस्ट ऑफ टुडे नॉर्वे के युवा सांसद श्री हिमांशु गुलाटी, और आज के हमारे सम्मानित अतिथि चौथी बार के चुने हुए सांसद श्री कमलजीत सिंह बख्शी. इनकी एज देख के लगता है कि चौथी बार के चुने हुए सांसद हैं, लगता बचपन में ही चुनाव जीत गए थे पहला चुनाव. विदेश मंत्रालय में हमारे सचिव श्री ज्ञानेश्वर मुले, स्पोर्ट्स मिनिस्टर की हमारी सचिव उपमा चौधरी, इस सभागार में उपस्थित गणमान्य अतिथिगण, और भारत से और विदेश के अनेक देशों से आए हुए मेरे बहुत ही नौजवान साथियों, आप सबके साथ मैं सबसे ज़्यादा अभिनंदन करना चाहूँगी गुलाटी जी के माता पिता जी का भी, जो विशेष रूप से इस पीबीडी में भाग लेने के लिए हमारे पास आए हैं और जिन्होंने हमें एक यंग सांसद नॉर्वे से दिया है. जहां तक इस पीबीडी का सवाल है, यह अपने आप में बहुत अनोखा और अनूठा पीबीडी है. जैसे योगी जी बता रहे थे कि पहले एक दिवसीय होता था, फिर दो दिवसीय हुआ, अब तीन दिवसीय हो गया. योगी जी, ये तीन दिवसीय नहीं, ये तो छह दिवसीय हो गया, क्योंकि 21 से 23 तक तो पीबीडी चलेगा. 21 को यूथ पीबीडी, दो दिन मेन पीबीडी, एक दिन प्रधानमंत्री जी रहेंगे, अगले दिन राष्ट्रपति जी रहेंगे, लेकिन 24 को हम सब आपके आमंत्रण पर प्रयागराज पहुंच जाएंगे, फिर 25 को दिल्ली दर्शन होगा और 26 को गणतंत्र दिवस परेड का दर्शन होगा. तो 21 से 26 तक दिस पीबीडी इज फ्रॉम 21st to 26th. ये तो तीन दिवसीय नहीं, डबल हुआ है, ये छह दिवसीय हुआ है. मुझे लगता है जब ये तालियां बज रही हैं तो शायद बीच वाले उससे नहीं बज रही, क्योंकि उन्हें शायद हिंदी समझ में नहीं आ रही है. मैं ऑब्जर्व कर रही हूँ इस बात को, तालियां इधर से बज रही हैं, तालियां उधर से बज रही हैं. माय यंग फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम ओवरसीज, आई एम स्विचिंग ओवर टू इंग्लिश सो दैट माय मैसेज कैन रीच यू ऑल्सो. आई वॉज ऑब्जर्विंग ओनली दीज पीपल एंड दोज पीपल वेयर क्लैपिंग, दे वर नॉट क्लैपिंग बिकॉज दे वर नॉट फॉलोइंग हिंदी. Now my message is for you. My young friends, you must be knowing that India has the largest diaspora in the world at almost 31 million. Means 3.1 crores. 31 million. And this diaspora is spread throughout the globe. However, what marks all of you is the shared common identity. And what is that? Indianness. And our shared common origin. What is that? India, our land of your forefathers. Here it is to celebrate these shared bonds that we have all gathered here. My young friends, the story of your forefathers' journey to distant shores is a tale brimming with courage, enterprise, and character. In ancient times, they left the Indian shores as traders, monks, teachers, and temple builders. But in the time of British Empire, they were sent to distant lands as indentured labor to work in the sugar, tea, and rubber plantations. They worked on lands as far as Fiji and Mauritius, Suriname and Sri Lanka, Trinidad and Tobago, Burma, Guyana, and Malaysia. The next wave of emigration saw Indian entrepreneurs and traders sailing fearlessly into uncharted waters of unknown countries. Since the 70s, young Indian professionals have been migrating abroad to corporate boardrooms, research labs, engineering workshops, and university faculties. We have seen the growing emigration of doctors, nurses, engineers, managers, plumbers, and electricians to West Asia and the Gulf. Today, we have people of Indian origin as heads of the state and heads of the government, and as heads of large multinational corporations, raising India's global profile. The success of each and every one of our emigrants is a testimonial to their unbeatable spirit, their dedication, and their patience and forbearance in the face of extreme hardships. Friends, while the Indian diaspora shared migrating centuries ago, it is a migration of the educated, highly skilled, and dynamic young Indians that has brought laurels to India. Today, many of the multinational corporations are headed by young Indian origin CEOs, whether it is Sundar Pichai of Google, Satya Nadella of Microsoft, Ajay Bang of MasterCard, or Geeta Gopinath of IMF. It is indisputable that Indians are leading the world today. Our diaspora has dramatically changed the world's perception of Indians and of India as well. They have kindled a new wave of appreciation for this land, which has produced and exported so many achievers. The benchmarks for success with the Pravasi community has set is a motivation for us in India. They encourage us to create a business, investment, and economic climate, which is as conducive to success as anywhere else in the world. Friends, to recognize the importance we place on engaging with our youth diaspora, we decided to start the Youth Pravasi Bharatiya Divas along with the Pravasi Bharatiya Divas Convention in 2015. This Youth Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is not only about discovering your roots and appreciating your heritage, but it is also about learning how you can be a part of India's development journey towards a new India. We would like to create an environment in India that will enable you to have the conviction that you and your children can excel in this country as much as you could anywhere else in the world. Whether you are looking for affordable quality education or tech startups, India offers limitless opportunities. Earlier, some of you and your forefathers left India in search of better opportunities for higher education. Today, the education sector in India has become very lucrative for your children to pursue higher education in India. India today is home to some of the best world-class university infrastructures and R&D capacities such as IITs and IIMs. Along with high-quality education, we want India to be a hub for high-end research and development capacities. We have started various programs such as Vajra, Gyan, and Mission Shodh Ganga to enable overseas scientific community to conduct high-end research and development in India. We have also increased the scope for the NRIs and OCI card holders to conduct better research in Indian institutions and universities. Today, India has over 41% of its 1.3 billion population below 20 years of age. I would like you to contribute to the higher education and research and development sectors with your technical expertise and knowledge sharing and help India harness its huge demographic dividend. Presently, about 7.5 lakh Indian students are pursuing higher education in research and innovation abroad. To address their grievances, we have constituted an expert group comprising ambassadors of foreign missions in Delhi, where majority of our students are pursuing higher education. We have held two meetings in 2018. The recommendations of this meeting are currently being considered. Every week, we come across stories of Indian youngsters making news in foreign countries with exciting achievements in academic and non-academic spheres. Reading about their journeys and odds that they have faced is quite inspirational and gives us hope that the citizens of the future have the potential to make the world better. During the last 4.5 years, we have taken several measures to safeguard immigration of Indian workers under the motto Surakshit Jao, Prashikshit Jao. We made online registration of foreign employers mandatory in 2015 to streamline overseas recruitment procedures and introduce safeguards into the migration cycle. Grievances, complaints, and petitions of the Indian migrant workers are being addressed online through eMigrate and Madad. We are taking strict action against illegal and fraudulent recruitment agents who are cheating Indian workers seeking overseas employment. We have an Indian Community Welfare Fund for carrying out welfare activities for distressed overseas Indians. We are strengthening the entire ecosystem of our administrative arrangements, and our embassies and our colleagues are proactively reaching out on social media to solve your problems in real-time basis. Friends, today we have pioneered the use of digital platforms and social media to actively enhance our outreach to the Indian diaspora. Today, we are present on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, Google+, SoundCloud, Flickr, as well as LinkedIn. We are disseminating real-time information about our bilateral and international relations and official engagements and creating awareness and understanding about India's foreign policy issues through the use of social media. We are using various other tools like podcasts and digital magazine to enhance our access to the diaspora youth. Our MEA app mobile application has brought all the websites and various social media handles of over 170 Indian missions on a common platform to further its public outreach. Our embassies have been proactive on the digital media, providing consular help and guidance. Whether it is Facebook or Twitter, help is just a message away from any Indian national in distress. आप जानते हैं कि अब भारत का पासपोर्ट हमारे प्रवासी भारतीयों का सुरक्षा कवच बन गया है. Our passport has become a security cover for our Indian diaspora. एक ट्वीट कीजिए, just 140 characters. रात के 12 बजे कीजिए, सुबह तड़के 3 बजे कीजिए, दोपहर के 3-4 बजे कीजिए, 24 घंटे के अंदर अंदर आपका समाधान होता है ना? इसीलिए मैंने कहा है, help is just one tweet away. My friends, many of your forefathers and ancestors migrated out of India generations ago. To reconnect their descendants to their origins and cultural heritage, we have several initiatives in place. Know India program, through which many of you are visiting India presently, is one such scheme that aims to give you a flavor of India and provide a platform for interaction with policy makers, industry, and civil society. गैदरिंग में केआईपी के लोग बैठे हैं नो इंडिया प्रोग्राम के तीन तरह खड़े हो जरा हाथ खड़े करो नो इंडिया प्रोग्राम वालों जस्ट सी फ्रॉम देयर और इस बार हम 50वां एडिशन मना रहे हैं तो हमारा गोल्डन जुबली सेलिब्रेशन भी है जितने 50 एडिशन हुए सबसे एक एक नो इंडिया प्रोग्राम का पार्टिसिपेंट हम लेकर आए हैं वो 50 पार्टिसिपेंट अलग से यहाँ बैठे ये देख ये हमारा बहुत ही प्यारा कार्यक्रम है बाहर से बच्चों को हम बुलाते हैं पीआईयूस को बुलाते हैं उनके बच्चे और वो यहाँ आकर 25 दिन घूमते हैं किसी पार्टनर स्टेट को हम लोग साथ में लेते हैं और ये बच्चे हैं जो इतने ज्यादा अभिभूत होकर के अभी आपके सामने चीयर्स कर रहे थे ये दिस प्रोग्राम रिकनेक्ट्स यू with Indian roots, culture, and heritage. And we have organized 49 editions of this program so far, as I've told you. I'm happy to note that the participant of the 50th KIP, or the Golden Jubilee edition, as also 51st and 52nd KIP, are also participating in the PBD convention. Another initiative, Bharat Ko Janiye Quiz, Know India Quiz program, which Prime Minister had launched for young overseas Indians, is another initiative which has received tremendous response. Over 40,000 overseas Indians registered in the second edition of this quiz. Wo bhi yahan baithe hain, jo jeet kar aaye hain. The winners will receive the medals from Honorable Prime Minister tomorrow during the inauguration of the 15th Prabhasi Bharatiya Divas Convention. We have also organized 7 conferences in 2018 to have a sustained dialogue with our diaspora experts on issues of relevance. One such conference was on engagement with younger members of diaspora. I'm happy that the outcomes of this conference will be discussed in the first plenary session here today. Abhi jo iske baad ka session hoga, usme usi conference ke charcha aap logon ke saath hogi, aap sare usme bhag lenge. We not only want to connect our youth diaspora to their ancestral land of India and to teach them to take pride in their history and civilizational heritage, but most importantly, we also want to engage you to participate in transforming India. Friends, as I told you earlier, India is one of the youngest countries in the world, with more than half of its billion population under 35 years of age. By 2020, the average age in India will be 29, making it the world's youngest country, with 64% of the population in the working age group. While countries like US, Western Europe, Japan, and even China are aging rapidly, India is getting younger and younger. By 2022, these aging countries will become super-aged, with over 1/3 of their population over 65 years of age, while India will have the world's largest working population. This demographic perspective offers India an unprecedented edge, which could further contribute to building a new, young India by 2022. Friends, it is projected that India will be the source of skilled manpower to the world by 2022. Our Skill India initiative is aimed towards making India ready to become the skill capital of the world by 2022. We have the Pravasi Kaushal Vikas Yojana, which aims to enhance the skills of Indian youth who seek overseas employment. Our aim is not to just export manpower to the world, but to export skills. Exporting skilled manpower will not only garner a better image for India on the global space, but will also lead to better salaries and better remittances, this raising India's GDP further. My young friends, through your talent and skill, you can benefit from immense opportunities that are arising with India's fast-paced development and transformation. India is now a land of innovation and startups. Contribution of Indian diaspora in technical field is exemplary. Nearly 16% of startups in Silicon Valley had an Indian co-founder. The figure for Indian startups is even higher in some areas such as business software. We can partner in building an infrastructure for skill development, which will contribute to greater employment in India as well as abroad. India is now recognized as one of the leading countries in science and technology. India has garnered world prestige in fields like supercomputing to space technology. Rapid technological advancement has to be matched up with training and educational infrastructure. In the last 4.5 years, under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi, the government has dismantled lots of rules and regulations and further opened up India's investment regime. We consider you as members of our extended family, and overseas Indians have been assigned a special place in the action agenda prepared for India's development till 2020 by Niti Aayog. We have launched a number of flagship programs to achieve our developmental objectives: the Smart Cities Mission, the Digital India, the Skill India, the Startup India, the Swachh Bharat campaign are all part of our efforts to realize the dream of a prosperous, skillful, enterprising, clean, and futuristic India. We want you to partner with us to realize that dream. At the Youth PBD, you will also have an opportunity to meet and interact with the young students who have come here from all over India, and especially from colleges and universities in Varanasi. I invite you to visit the exhibition at the PBD convention, which showcases the flagship programs, state government's initiatives, and Indian craft and cultural bazaar, and see for yourself the exciting story that India has to offer. Before I conclude, let me take this opportunity on behalf of Ministry of External Affairs to place my sincere gratitude to the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports and the Government of Uttar Pradesh for their support in making this event पॉसिबल. मैं आप सबका दोबारा बहुत बहुत स्वागत करती हूँ, हृदय से अभिनंदन करती हूँ. और आज के इस कार्यक्रम को सफल बनाने में सबसे बड़ी भूमिका आप लोगों की है, इसलिए आप सबको मेरा हाथ जोड़कर अभिवादन, नमस्कार, धन्यवाद.
As Honorable Minister just said, Indianness will be celebrated like never before. अनेक अनेक धन्यवाद मैम.